Let's start out by looking at the Revit user interface. In the upper left, we have the quick access toolbar. Across the entire top, we call this the title bar, which lists the program name and the file that you're in and a view that you have open. On the far right, you have the area where you log into Revit and access help. Below all of this, we have the ribbon, which on the far left starts with the file tab, also known as the application menu. And then we have various tabs for the ribbon across the top. Below the ribbon, we have something called the options bar. So when we're in a certain command, like the wall command, you can see there's contextual information related and helpful to drawing walls in Revit. On the left, we have these two palettes that can be rearranged. The default location is as shown here. On the top, we have the properties palette, which shows information either for the current view or for the selected item or the command that you're in. The top part of the properties palette is called the type selector. This allows you to select different wall types, text styles, or even title blocks while you're working in Revit. Below the properties palette, we have the project browser. This gives us access to views, sheets, schedules, and content that is loaded into the current Revit project. To the right, we have the canvas or drawing area. We have different tabs that can be open to jump between a first floor plan view or an exterior elevation view or a door schedule, for example. Below this view, we have the view control bar. There's one of these for each view that you have that's current. Across the entire bottom is the status bar. In the lower left, you'll see prompts for what Revit is expecting you to do. To the right, there are various settings, including selection control toggles. And then finally, to the right, we have the navigation bar, which gives us various controls for navigating the current view. And that's it. So these terms are really helpful to understand as you work through the Autodesk Revit residential textbook I wrote by SDC Publications.